proud privilege to welcome our Honorable Vice Chairman, Sir Shri Arpit Chadha ji. May I request the audience to kindly have a big round of applause for our Vice Chairman, Sir Shri Arpit Chadha ji. Thank you so much, sir, for being the part of the program today. I would not like to leave this opportunity to listen to you, sir. So may I request you, sir, to kindly address the audience with your kind words. May I request you, sir, please?
Very, very good morning to each one of you. Initially, I would like to apologize for being a little late for the program. I was in another orientation of MCA program running in our institute. MCA also starts today only, actually. We've got the inauguration of MCA program. I was thrilled and I was lucky enough to join this program when Dr. Vinishil Gautam sir was speaking. I personally have always admired him, followed him, and listening to him today was like a dream come true. I don't know how many of you listened to him, like he was saying. Some of you must be messaging or talking to each other, which is literally a crime when you've got people like him on the dais speaking. And I'm sure even if you take back 50 or 60% of what he said, it would make your day and it would make your life. And I'm not saying just for the sake of pleasing, sir, but I honestly admired each and every word which he said. It was like a guru speaking to his students, to his shishyas. I hope you all listen to him and it would go a long way. Respected Dr. Amitabh Rajan sir, IAS ex Home Secretary and Additional Chief Secretary of Maharashtra, again someone I really admired, and we've been lucky enough at ITS to have him here and share his experience and knowledge with you all. Let me welcome each and every student of MBA 1820 batch to ITS Parivar, ITS family, that is how we address ourselves, family of 8,000 students. ITS embarked its journey in 1995 with 180 students, and over the years expanded because of trust in the quality of education being provided by us. We have always believed in providing good quality education to our students at ITS. It would be no different for you all. We would provide you with a lot of opportunities during your two-year stay with us. Opportunities on the academic front, industry interactions, something similar to what you witnessed today, two experts sitting on the dais. There would be a lot of opportunities for you to interact with the academicians, with the industry people. Just make sure you have a patient listening ear and you listen and take back the experience which they've learned over the years and ended up being where they are today. That is extremely successful. And they can motivate you no end if you're ready to be motivated. Nothing can be achieved unless you are willing to achieve something. So personality development would also be part of your curriculum. And above all, we would try and hone you with skills which would set you to be employable in the global market. Like rightly sir said, we are not employment giving companies or something, but we will make sure that you have the skills. Until and unless you aren't ready to own those skills, you cannot. Grab every opportunity which comes your way. Enjoy your stay with ITS. Trust yourself. Trust your decision to pursue an MBA course at ITS. Never give up. Best example, if I may give so, something which each Indian follows, that is cricket. Never give up. Best example is the captain of Indian cricket team, Virat Kohli. Last when he toured England, he could not get back to the ball. And now, he's a run machine. Every innings he goes to bat in England, he's scoring 50 or 100. So that is just the dedication of the man. Success does not come easy. You have to work hard. You have to give hours on whatever you are doing in life. Life is all about how you see, interpret it, and accept things. Next 2 years, you would be given good education, something for which you have joined ITS. Assignments, projects, etc. Somewhere you might feel it tough, but never give up, as I said. All this, which would be done at ITS, would be for your good. I'll end up with a small story, something which I think can motivate you all. I had it on my iPad, but sadly the battery went off, but I was lucky enough to take a picture of the iPad, and I would just read the story from my mobile phone. The story is like positives in negatives. A young woman was sitting at her dining table, worried about taxes to be paid, housework to be done. And to top it all, her family was coming over for Thanksgiving the next day. She was not feeling very thankful at that time. As she turned her gaze sideways, she noticed her young daughter scribbling furiously into her notebook. The daughter said, "My teacher asked us to write a paragraph on negative Thanksgiving for homework today," said the daughter. "She asked us to write down things that we are thankful for, things that make us feel not so good in the beginning, but turn out to be good after all." With curiosity, the mother peeked into the book. This is what her daughter wrote. "I'm thankful for the final exams, because that means school is almost over. I'm thankful for back-tasting medicines, because it helps us feel better. I'm thankful for waking up to alarm clocks, because it means I am still alive." It then dawned on the mother that she had a lot of things to be thankful for. She thought again. She had to pay taxes, but that meant she was fortunate to be employed. She had housework to do, but that meant she had her own home to live in. She had to cook for a family for Thanksgiving, but that meant she had a family with whom she could celebrate. The moral of this story is very simple. Why am I sharing this story with you? We generally complain about negative things in life. We do not see the positive aspects of life. 2 years you would be at ITS. You would be given unlimited opportunities. It's up to you to grab onto them. As a student, even when I was at your age, I might have complained that my institute did not give me this, did not give me that. Do not do that. Make the most of the opportunities. And I am sure that there would be endless opportunities. Any institute's backbone is teachers, and we are blessed to have the best teachers here. Make best use of those teachers. Challenge those teachers. If there's any doubt in your mind, do not keep it to yourself. Throw it to the teacher. And I'm sure you'll get an answer to your query. Your question might be relevant or irrelevant to the subject of the classroom, but do not keep it to yourself. Do not take back any question in your mind. Give it to your teachers and ask them for an answer. Good luck. Keep learning. God bless us all. Thank you.